Okay, certainly a lot of practice in these problems, I notice, and I'm looking at it and I'm kind of wondering what to do, but I do like the augmented matrix, by the way, and I'll write that down for you. And I'm seeing, you know, something, it looks pretty simple, 1, 0, 1, and then I see 1, 1, and then a 2, relatively simple, and I get 2. I like the numbers, by the way, -1, and then I get a 1, and I get a bar, 3, 2, 5. Now, if you're sloppy and you can't read your writing and you're doing work, probably not going to pay off. But let's take a look at some things, all right? And I'm just looking around for things I can do. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do, let's see, -1 × (1) (+)(3), give it to (3). All right, I think I can do it, right? And when I do that, I'm going to actually write down. So you get -1 + 1 = 0. Then you get -1 + 2, which is 1. You get -2 + 1, which is -1. And then what do you get? You get -3 + 5, which is 2. All right, let me get my eraser out, and I can put that in (3)'s position now. Get him a smaller eraser, though. Give me one moment. So what do you get? I get 0. I get 1. I get -1, and I get a 2. And, you know, I noticed something right away. I noticed that those last two rows are identical. So I'm going to go through it. I mean, the fact that they're both the same. But what I'm going to do this over here. I'm going to do, you know, -1 × (2) + (3), and give it to (3). And, you know, I'm going to just erase this now because I know it produces 0. So I'll put this over here. Now, a lot of students get very confused by this. But I want to point out what it really says to me. It says 0 × (z) is equal to 0. Well, looking at that, I'm going to say z can be any real number. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to say z is equal to a. This is very typical. That's any real number, by the way. It's some number. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go backwards. I'm going to go this one over here. And let's take a look at what it says. It says y - z. Well, I said z was a, right? And what's that going to equal? 2. So what's y equal to? Let's see, 2 + a. So again, if I were to determine what a was, like I said, a was 7, y would be 9. But a could be any number in the universe. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go back to this line over here. Let's write that down. What does it give you? x + y. What's y? Y is 2 + a. And what's z? It's a, and I got 2 of those, so I'll put 2a down. And what's that equal to? 3. Let's write that down. It's kind of the last thing we're going to be doing. So it's x + 2 + 3a equals 3. Well, I want to know what x is, and x is going to be, let's see, take away 2 from both sides, you get 1, and then subtract 3a from both sides, and you get this over here. All right, let's take a look at the k and see if I got the right answer. Z equals a, y equals 2 + a, and x equals 1 - 3a. We're doing fine. Thank you.